My pieces are humorous. My pieces are whimsical. Sometimes there's a little deeper meaning. There's a little different level there. It depends on the piece, of course. There are some things that are just absolutely pure fun and pure stupid.
Next on Gallery, Ardmore artist Freeman Loughridge likes to say he's recycling the world, one sculpture at a time. And for the type of sculpture he creates, Freeman uses a little love and a lot of junk. He's always been fascinated by things others have discarded, turning mess into masterpiece. Freeman Loughridge and something called Funk Skull. This is Gallery, exploring the arts and culture of Oklahoma.
Major funding for Gallery is made possible by the Kirkpatrick Foundation, advancing creativity and cultural education in Oklahoma. And the Pauline Dwyer Mecklenburg and Robert A. Mecklenburg Jr. Foundation. Additional funding by the Kerr Foundation, Jasmine and Melvin Moran, and Simmons Allspa, Oklahoma Arts Council, and by the Kirkpatrick Family Fund.
It's all just junk, let's face it. In the end, it's all junk. And one of the things that appeals to me about using the junk is that I take objects that were everyday objects that people have discarded, and I bring them back, put them together in a new way, and present them again. And it's kind of fun to bring them back. I don't know what we'd use this one for, but by God, we're not going to pass it up. Got a nice little round end on it. Could be an eyeball or something like that. Well, like deer hunting, some days you don't see anything. The shop has thousands of pieces in it. I don't want to count, and I sure don't want to move anytime soon. But most of the things are welded together, but if it can be welded, screwed, glued, or riveted together, it still works for sculpture. These are off a little lawnmower. That'd be a great base. Or look, I love the star there. It could be like decoration for a bull or a horse or something. I don't know. It's got a lot of fun things there happening. And some things you find are almost ready-made. Had this piece for a while. This is an old master cylinder, probably out of a 40s car, maybe 50s. It was an under-the-floor master cylinder for the brake and the clutch. But it's sort of frozen in position, so it's kind of like a almost a running man. It's already ready to go, so I haven't made anything out of it yet because it's just too darn easy. It's too simple, so he kind of hangs around here waiting for me to get ready for him. Well, one reason I have so many objects in the shop is so when I get back to the shop, I've got plenty of things to draw from, and I try to hang as many things on the wall as I can and put them out in the open so I can see them. And I'll be looking around the shop for something, and I'll pick up a piece, and it'll trigger the next thing I'm going to make. My pieces are humorous. My pieces are whimsical. Sometimes there's a little deeper meaning. There's a little different level there. It depends on the piece, of course. There are some things that are just absolutely pure fun and pure stupidness, pure craziness. But there are some things that have a little social commentary to them. The object actually drives a lot of the pieces. This is the driving force behind some of the pieces. I'll pick up an object, look at the object, and then kind of tells me what other objects want to go with it and what direction to go. Okay, I think that ought to do it. I think I'll go with that. Think it over and weld it now. Put it together. And before I start welding everything together, I lay the pieces out on the table or on the floor, and I'll start tacking them together, because the tack welding, which is just a little bit of arc welding, just enough to hold something together, that's pretty much my drawing. I tack it all together. I look at it. If I don't like it, I break it apart. I take a piece off of it before I go ahead and do the final hard weld. And that's the way I build a piece. So if I build it in three dimension instead of drawing it, then I have a lot more success. This is Maria's garden, and she's my exclusive outlet here in Ardmore. And I actually built this gate. I let her do most of the work. I just make stuff.
Well, this one is called If It Walks Like a Duck.
Oh,
and this is a personal one of mine, but quite interesting. And I love to know what they're made of. For instance, mm-hmm. this, can you guess? Bathtub leg, turned upside
okay.
down. And the little clamps.
And rebar.
Rebar feet, little piece of tulle back here for his feet. Uh-huh. And
I could disguise the objects. I could cut them all apart. I could weld them back together in such a way that they would be a sculpture. And you wouldn't recognize what the items are. But I really like to leave the items, because that's a contact with your viewer.
Now what is this head? That looks like some sort of... I don't know what that is. It seems familiar, but...
It does, doesn't it?
So many people will come up and they'll ask me when I'm doing a show, they'll ask me, they'll pick out an item in a sculpture, they'll ask me, do you know what this is? And I always say no, even when I know what it is, because I want to hear their story. If they're asking me if I know, then they have a story. They're going to tell me what it is. And they'll tell me memories of their childhood and memories of using a particular tool. And that's the connection with the viewer. Well, this is Domestic Surfer preparing to hang 10. There's the 10 hangers back there for her to do it with. I actually found this on beside the road one day, the ironing board. And I had another piece that I was working on at the shop, and I just stopped immediately and built this piece because I knew right away what it had to be. The old ironer for her feet, and it just worked out. It was one of these things that just fell together. It's something I didn't have to struggle with at all. I'm not sure where all the ideas for all the pieces come from, but part of being an artist, in fact, being an artist, the entire part of being an artist is vision. Let's take a look at it and see where we're going. Okay. And also the imagination of what those shapes and those shadows could become. And that's what being an artist is. It's all vision. All right. I like it.